Good evening. Welcome to Reporters Diary on the Eco of India's Facebook page. Before we are joined by the reporters, here are the important stories we are tracking today. Supreme Court today rejected a plea seeking postponement of joint entrance main and NEET undergraduate examinations. The exams were scheduled to be conducted next month. The three-judge bench hearing the plea said precious year of students cannot be wasted. Union government is now ready with a roadmap to promote indigenously developed weapons and military platforms. According to Defense Ministry sources, the government will use diplomatic channels to do these promotions in the overseas markets. Days after Nepalese Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli called Prime Minister Narendra Modi on the occasion of India's Independence Day, senior diplomats of two countries today held a virtual meeting to review progress of different India-aided development projects in Nepal. Coronavirus outbreak in Auckland has now led to delay in New Zealand's election by nearly a month. Instead of September 19, the elections will be held on October 17. The delay was sought by opposition parties after Auckland was put under lockdown due to virus outbreak. West Bengal has decided to observe September 1st as Police Day from this year. Announcing the decision, Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee today said through this, the state government will honor sacrifices made by police personnel while fighting the ongoing pandemic. And now I'm joined by our team of reporters, Razia, Asmita, Riddhi, Debanjan. Welcome to Reporters Diary. Asmita, we move on with you. What all stories we are having today?
Safi, today we have some disturbing news from Siliguri. That five young boys, all under 22, went for a picnic by a private vehicle on August 15 on the Independence Day towards Kashyang. And they had gone missing after that. Today, bodies of four of them have been recovered near Kashyang. And it seemed to be a road accident, and police are trying to ascertain the cause. And another thing that we need to take a look at is the agitation of section of employees from GTA who demanded regularizations of their services. In fact, many of them were appointed during the SWL Darjeeling Gorkha Hill Council under Subhash Ghosh. And this two news from Siliguri and another news that coming from Gangtok Z and that we are looking at is the plight of patients at District Hospital Mangan in North Sikkim. It should be mentioned that Gangtok is 100 kilometers away from Mangan, and there is a gynecologist or orthopedic at this district hospital. Imagine the plight of ladies. If a pregnant woman has labor pain all of a sudden and she has to be referred to Gangtok hospital, and it's a pathetic service. And that's all I have as of now. Of course,
more all right, we move on. Yes. Thanks, Asmita. Riddhi, what are the things, what are the points in news today with you?
The nation story that I have today is a great relief for Congress, especially for Priyanka Gandhi Vadra, as Supreme Court today dismissed a plea against Congress leader Priyanka Gandhi Vadra, Milind Deora, and co-founder of Yes Bank, Rana Kapoor, for alleged fraud and cheating as petition filed by an NGO. Another story that I have, Minority Affairs Minister Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi today lauded the Prime Minister Narendra Modi government for the containing of the pandemic situation in our country. That's all from my side today, Safi.
All right, thanks, Riddhi. Debanjan, big stories at our end today here.
Yeah, quite big, I must say. Row erupted at the prestigious Vishwabharati University campus this morning over erection of a wall that saw protest, huge protest by local people, and a rally was led by Dubrajpur MLA Noresh Bauri. Actually, it started 2 days back. Local traders protested a decision taken by Vishwabharati University to erect a wall to prevent entry of outsiders to the Poushmela ground. The Poushmela is a traditional festival of Vishwabharati, which thousands of people from various parts of the country come to visit. But citing an NGT directive, the Vishwabharati University has decided to not organize the fair from this year, protesting against these local traders. On Saturday, rushed to the spot and stopped the construction of the wall. And today, after the rally was held by the local MLA, a huge ruckus erupted there. A gate of the Vishwabharati University was broken. A makeshift office that was developed in the campus that was ransacked. And after that, according to sources, the university authority has also decided to keep the university closed for till further notice. Governor Jagdeep Dhankar has reacted to this. He has tweeted and has also talked to Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee. And later in the afternoon, at a press conference, Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee has said that though this is a central university and she would not like to comment much on this issue, she said that I don't want any kind of construction to be done in the Vishwabharati campus. And another story, which is once again sad, I will say, another TMC MLA, Samaresh Das, TMC MLA from Agra, has died today. He was admitted to Pashkura Hospital with symptoms of COVID-19. And this morning, wee hours today, he passed away. And another thing that I must like to add with this, former State Minister Krishnendu Narayan Chaudhary is now in home isolation as he has been tested positive with COVID-19. That's all.
Okay, these are some really sad pieces, some really sad news which is coming. And today, we will now move on to Port Blair. Razia, what big stories Port Blair is making news? Anything important we have today?
Important means, COVID-19 is of course important for everyone these days. The rising COVID-19 number and that death rates are increasing day by day. As usual, the administration is keep on requesting people to stay away, stay at home. If not necessary, don't go out. And the lockdown, as you all know, till 18th, tomorrow is the last day of second lockdown here. And people are here, people are talking that maybe the lockdown will increase till 25th of this month because the number is high here, positive cases numbers are high. And the second thing which I want to tell you, Safi, that is the Pradhan of Neel Island. It's a small tourist destination. And even after the launch of Kani submarine OFC cable here, the internet connectivity is very poor. And the Pradhan of Neel Island has written a letter to the chief general manager of BSNL to connect Shaheed Beep with the Kani OFC so that the people from these small tiny islands should get a better connectivity, better internet services from island. So that's all, Shafi, from Andaman. Today.
Right, so these are major points which our reporters are tracking all across Bengal, in Sikkim and in Andaman. So thank you Asmita, Razia, Riddhi and Dibanjan for joining Reporters Diary this evening. Viewers, thanks for watching, and tomorrow you will be able to watch us again at 6:30. So please do join us for Reporters Diary, which is a program that brings to you the development through the day that takes place through our reporters. So see you again tomorrow at 6:30. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.